Good afternoon, graduands, and welcome to your graduation. University can be a challenging experience, especially for those who have had to overcome personal struggles to get to this point today. For this reason, I'd like to be the first person to say congratulations to everybody graduating today. Now's the point where I get to say some boring words about housekeeping and stuff. So, it's a good time now to make sure your phones are on silent or turned off. Pictures of other people's food will still be on Instagram after the ceremony. Graduands, you will have all been allocated a seat number at registration. Please make sure you are sitting in the correct seat now, as this is the order you will be called out in when you collect your certificate. Pause for graduands to check seat names. When the marshal ushers you, please remain in the same order as you make your way up to the nave. So going that way and round. And around your left to the side aisle. You should carry your cap in your left hand. When your name is called, you will go across the platform, shake hands with our Vice-Chancellor and Chancellor, and collect your certificate as you leave the stage. When you leave the stage, don't go down those little steps, because we've been told that some people get really angry. So just go that way around instead, there. You will then go and sit down again, moving straight down the row. You may not be returning to the same seat you started in, but that's okay, it's only a chair. One of the things we're extremely proud of here at BG is that our students are a name and not just a number. And today of all days, we want to ensure that every single name is heard clearly as you are called to collect your certificates. We want to celebrate the success of each and every graduate. So please clap and whoop if you're a whooper, but please try and keep it to 2 to 3 seconds per name. I can hear you rolling your eyes and some people laughing, but we really do want to ensure that every name can be heard as our graduates are called to the platform. So now, you're gonna roll your eyes again. We're gonna do a practice clap. Might seem ridiculous, but lean into it, it's a bit of fun. So, I'm gonna get you to cheer for some types of gray, because if you can cheer for the color gray, you can cheer for anything. So, let's go for silver gray. Oh, come on, stop quicker than that, please. Charcoal gray. Slate grey. I heard an oi 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 for slate grey, I liked it. And can we try some whooping for Spanish grey? I won't read out the other 46. If you can put as much enthusiasm and passion into all the claps as you did for grey this afternoon will be fantastic. Congratulations again for all the hard work that has got you here today, and I hope you all have an incredible graduation. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Would you please be seated? On behalf of the Cathedral Chapter, may I welcome you to your cathedral today. We're delighted that you celebrate your achievements here. It's fitting too, as the cathedral was founded to be a place of learning. We value our special relationship with Bishop Grotesti University, which as a Church of England foundation continues to express that Christian ethos in which scholarship is fostered in a transformative context that nurtures a sense of purpose and vocation. So we celebrate with you all that you have made of your God-given abilities, expressing our thanks today to partners and friends, to parents and guardians, colleagues, and of course your academic staff, and we wish you every blessing for your future. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in you are hidden all knowledge and wisdom. We pray today for those who celebrate their achievements in learning, that they may bring forth the fruits of your blessings in lives of service. This we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
I hereby declare this congregation for the conferment of degrees and awards to be open. I welcome all who are here gathered for this ceremony.
Madam Chancellor, Mr. Mayor, Mr. Canon Chancellor, distinguished civic guests, honoured guests, graduands, ladies and gentlemen. As Vice-Chancellor of Bishop Grotesti University, it gives me huge pleasure to welcome you all to this, our 2018 graduation, which is the academic high point of the year for all of us. And I'm particularly pleased to welcome our friends and colleagues and students from our partner colleges to this ceremony: Boston, Grantham, Lincoln, North Lindsay, New College, Stamford. You're most welcome. And I sincerely hope that this will be one of the most memorable days in the lives of our graduating students, particularly those who are coming to the end of a very successful period of study. Because those of you graduating today should rightly be proud of your enormous achievement in gaining a university qualification. And we all join with you in celebrating your accomplishments. This is your day, and I have to say that you all look absolutely fantastic in your colours and gowns. I should like to take the opportunity to thank the Dean and the Chapter of the Cathedral for helping us make these ceremonies so special every year. This year, however, is the first time that I've been able to say welcome back to the Cathedral, because many of you will have taken part in our first ever matriculation ceremony, which took place here 3 years ago. But I do hope that you, as the person who sat here 3 years ago, is not the same person who is sitting here today. Because if your time as a student with us has not changed you, then something has gone terribly wrong. Because higher education is all about transformation. It's about changing lives. It's about bringing the best out in all of you. There is a current debate being fueled by the media on the value of higher education. But the focus of that debate tends to be very narrow, looking solely at how much graduates earn when they finish their studies. But value is much broader than that. And if I want to find evidence of the value of higher education, I need look no further than those of you sitting in front of me now, because you are testimony to the transformational power of university study. Your higher education has assisted you to become successful learners, successful researchers, experts in your academic discipline, having developed the various graduate attributes in the course of your study. You have engaged in critical thinking. You're now much more self-confident and self-aware, so that you now don't just follow trends, but you set them. You don't simply accept the status quo, but you challenge it for the greater good of society and of others. These are just some of the key benefits of your time with us. But there are some other rather interesting and possibly surprising additional benefits which have been highlighted in a large number of research reports written over the years. Let me see if you recognise any of these. Graduates are said to be less likely to commit crime, less likely to drink excessively, less likely to smoke, and less likely to be obese. But they are more likely to vote, to be involved in volunteering and civic engagement. They're more likely to have general better health throughout their lives, and they're more likely to enjoy a longer life. So I wonder if you recognise yourself in some of these. But there are also other benefits which you experience, which in turn benefit society and the economy, such as higher earnings for graduates, less exposure to unemployment, increased skills development, and increased entrepreneurial activity and productivity. But employment is, of course, an important element, and I can assure you that as graduates of this institution, you are highly sought after, as national statistics state year after year. This year, 97% of our students were in full-time employment or in full-time study leading to employment 6 months after graduation. So graduates coming from our institutions are highly employable. Remember that we are a TEF Gold institution, being awarded the gold for excellence in teaching and the student experience. So you have a lot to be proud of in taking the name Bishop Gross test with you, because you represent that quality. But I realise that it has not all been plain sailing. And during your studies, I am very much aware that some of you have had personal, professional, and health struggles to overcome. And the staff who work with you and I realise that several of you have had to balance so many conflicting priorities in order to allow you to study. And at times you have had to make difficult decisions and perhaps sacrifices. But all of you have overcome the challenges, or you're still in a position of working your way through them. And you're here today to celebrate, and you deserve special credit for pushing yourselves. And I can assure you that my colleagues and I very much admire your determination, your perseverance, and indeed your resilience. In the words of Marcus Aurelius, our actions may be impeded, but there can be no impeding our intentions. In other words, we all face temporary setbacks, but these are not permanent, and when we overcome them, we are the stronger for having had the experiences. I also realise that some sitting here are the first in their families ever to attend higher education, and that can be scary in so many ways, with the expectations of the whole wider family resting on your shoulders, and you can feel a sense of that additional pressure. But you have succeeded, and your success is the success of your wider family and those who have supported you. Everyone here gaining a qualification has, of course, been supported by someone, by families, by friends, by your peers, by work colleagues, and by a whole range of people you have worked with in the university and in placements. The quality of education you receive at BG has been enhanced by these partnerships that we have with schools, the business community, the voluntary sector, our FE and HE partners, local councils, the health community, and many other stakeholders. So whatever our supporter base has been, I would like us all just to take a moment to applaud those who have supported us in so many different ways. Thank you. I said in my opening that this was the end of your studies, but it also represents a new beginning, because today you will enter a new phase when you become alumni of the university, former students, and I really hope that you will cherish a part of BG as you move on in your career, and that you will be ambassadors for us locally, nationally, or internationally in ways that are unique to you. Some of you may go on to do postgraduate study, some will go on to do doctorates, but I hope that whatever you do, you will consider partnership working with us in some way. In 15 months' time, you will be contacted and asked about your employment or study status, and I hope that you will be able to communicate that information to whoever's collecting the data, because these are the data that give us the statistics about how many of our graduates are in employment or in study. At the end of the ceremony, I do hope you will come back to the campus to continue the celebrations. But each year, we try to have something unique that sets our graduation apart from all the others. Last year, we remembered the 800th anniversary of the signing of the Charter of the Forest. In 2015, when many of you started, we celebrated the 800th anniversary of Magna Carta. This year, it's both the centenary of the RAF and also of women getting the vote. And we have celebrated both on campus in different ways. And this morning, we honoured one of the senior RAF officers, Air Chief Marshal Sir Michael Graydon, as an honorary graduate. And we're very much hoping that tomorrow the Red Arrows will make an appearance at 3 o'clock precisely, when they will do a flyover over the cathedral and over the campus. Some of you may hear them, others may see them, but we will all be able to say that we were there in 2018 when the Red Arrows celebrated our graduation with us. Sometimes living in this county, we take the Red Arrows a bit for granted, but they are a national icon and they're very special. And I am personally delighted that they're going to fly over to support us tomorrow. But whatever the outcome, I hope that you will have a wonderful day. And again, on behalf of the wider university community, may I congratulate you on gaining your qualification. And thank you again for being with us over these years, for being students, and now for being such great ambassadors. Thank you. Madam Chancellor, I now call upon you to accept the recommendations of Senate with regard to the candidates we shall present to you, including those graduating in absentia.
Madam Chancellor, we present these candidates to you today that you may confer upon them the degree of Bachelor of Arts professional studies, childhood and youth, with first-class honours and the Chancellor and University Council Award for Academic Achievement, Pamela Wilson. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Professional Studies, Childhood and Youth, with honours, Sharon Bratley. Kerry Davies. Karina Garfoot. Charlotte Harness. Sarah Harper. Alexandra Harrison. Victoria Wright. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Professional Studies, Early Childhood, with First Class Honours and the Chancellor and University Council Award for Academic Achievement, Kerry Lester. Winner of the Ede and Ravenscroft Prize for Student Orator, Julie Murray. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Professional Studies, Early Childhood, with Honours, Keely Benton. Chelsea Booth. Chantelle Chalice. Kaylee Chatterton. Sonia Church. Samantha Clifford. Shelley Cobb. Cassandra Cook. Bethany Cooper. Kirsty Cooper. Hannah Cumberworth. Fiona Dawson. Shannon Downey. Katie Ford. Laura Graytrick. Sadie Harris. Holly Henderson. Ryan Hinson. Claire Hollin. Amelia Rose Hughes. Lynn Jameson. Lauren G. Sarah Johnson. Claire Kirby. Kelly Lindsay. Hannah Longman. Michelle McGowan. Ailish Main. Lisa Miller. Katrina Oswin. Lindsay Porter. Stephanie Ross. Laura Rowe. Amy Sedgwick. Lisa Shawley. Della Smith. Kirsty Smithson. Elizabeth Soper. Bobby Stead. Laura Swales. Sophie Talbot. Sharon Torrey. Holly Turley. Katie Williams. Denise Wing. Samantha Wooding. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Professional Studies, Education, with First Class Honours and the Chancellor and University Council Award for Academic Achievement, Georgia Constanti. Emma Fitzsimmons. Donna Moore. Nicola O'Brien. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Professional Studies, Education, with honours, Lauren Abbott. Nicole Berry. Rachel Bowler. Jessica Chadburn. Benjamin Crandley. Kelly Dean. Charlotte Ellica. Kathleen Gibson. Mariam Hyatt. Sally Jane Hewitt. Amy Hicks. Carla Hopkins. Jane Kelly. Mary Lavelle. Roisin Locke. Kaylee Marklew. Charlene Middlebrook. Shalane Sanderson. Amanda Small. Katie Smith. Adam Stanley. Amanda Ward. Lisa Wells. Deborah Wood. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts, Professional Studies, Education, Rebecca Jones. Stephen Quinlan. For the Foundation degree, Professional Studies, Childhood and Youth, Stephanie Marsh. Natasha Shields. For the Foundation degree, Professional Studies, Early Childhood, Amy Abbott. Rachel Allen. Claire Corston. Jennifer Clifford. Kerry Davidge. Louisa Dixon. Emily Dodds. Karen Elliott. Emma Frith. Sarah Hardy. Charlotte Harris. Holly Hunt. Julie Jennings. Jennifer Jones. Laura Martin. Natalie Rippin. Stephanie Robertson. For the Foundation degree, Professional Studies Education, with distinction, and the Chancellor and University Council Award for Academic Achievement, Coral Capon. Winner of the British Foundation of Women Graduates Lincolnshire Award for an Outstanding Foundation Degree student intending to teach, Nicole Orris. For the Foundation Degree, Professional Studies, Education, Samantha Appleton. Rachel Atkinson. Angela Beeston. Charlotte Butler. Danielle Callis. Chloe Coupland. Shona Coy. Fleur Kustens. Ebony Delaney. Jetta Denton. Jennifer Dyer. Hannah Kerr. Claire Eve. Georgina Gardner. Sharon Hamilton. Leanne Holman. Sam Hughes. Helen Jefferson. Emma Jones. Emma Lonsdale. Jessica Marsh. Charlotte Massingham. Caroline Matthews. Jade Mays. Rebecca Munt. Hannah Peters. Rebecca Riddle. Nicole Taylor. Matthew Vernon. Suzanne Watson. Ethan Wilson. Danielle Winters. Degrees awarded at Boston College. For the foundation degree, Applied Studies, Early Childhood, with distinction, and the Chancellor and University Council Award for Academic Achievement, Victoria Thompson. For the foundation degree, Applied Studies, Early Childhood, Catherine Burr. Stacey Clark. Siobhan Evans. Stacey Feary. Rachel Hardy. Natalie Haywood. Daisy Howard. Stephanie Hull. Jasmine Lilly. Amanda Long. Joanne Overton. Gemma Smith. Jill Stanley. Zoe Thickpenny. Michaela Wiley. For the foundation degree, Applied Studies, Learning Support, with distinction, and the Chancellor and University Council Award for Academic Achievement, Ashley Frankish. Ryan Leggett. For the foundation degree, Applied Studies, Learning Support, Louise Austin. Gary Backhouse. Shanice Boyfield. Shannon Clare. Tracy Hill. Lindsay Jackson. Corey Jeeves. Lauren Kitching. Claire Lovett. Verity Moore.
Victoria Moore. Chandni Patel. Becky Thompson. Paula Trollope. Degrees awarded at Grantham College. For the foundation degree, special educational needs and disability, Pamela Fitton. Chloe Johnson. Hazel Johnson. Degrees awarded at Lincoln College. For the degree of Bachelor of Science, Sports Coaching, Development and Pedagogy, with honours, Sarah Caddy. Emma Louise Johnson. Jamie Lewis. Benjamin Ryder. Lucy Ward. For the degree of Bachelor of Science, Sports Therapy, with honours, Olivia Brown. Adrian Short.
It's me great pleasure to introduce one of today's graduates who will be giving the closing oration and has graduated with the degree of Bachelor of Professional Studies, Early Childhood, Julie Murray.
Good afternoon. Reflecting on the last 3 years gives me an enormous sense of pride at what I and everyone here today has achieved. I must be honest though and acknowledge that this degree was not a solo effort. I think it's fair to say that there are many people who have played a part in supporting us. I'm sure that you all know who you are, and thank you. Like others, I've experienced more than my fair share of challenges during my time at BGU. However, being determined and persevering are worthwhile skills to cope with life's hurdles. The sense of satisfaction at achieving a degree despite these adversities is second to none. It's certainly been a roller coaster ride from enrolment to graduating today in the cathedral. There are times that the past 3 years have seemed endless, yet in other ways they've flown by, and it's almost a feeling of sadness that we have come to the end of the course. I recall waiting to collect assignment results, feeling physically sick with fear, then experiencing a sense of elation when I read the feedback and most importantly the grade, and this spurred me on to complete the next module. Each assignment I received back has boosted my self-confidence a little bit more, and I began to believe that I could do this. Well, we did do this, and today we've been presented with our degrees. We have a lot to celebrate, and I hope you enjoy celebrating with us all. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Julie. I now invite the musicians of the university to give a short recital. They will sing Non Nobis Domine by William Byrd and I Was Glad by Hubert Parry.
Non nobis domine.
I now declare this congregation closed and invite all those present to stand while the procession and our new graduates depart. Graduates, as befits your new status as members of our academic community, we ask you to join the procession out onto the west front while guests remain in their places. Thank you.